Morning children, welcome to our EBS session. See this lesson is the being safe. Safe means, what is the meaning of safe? We have to live with the safe. Surakshitanga undadam, surakshitanga jeevinchadam, surakshitanga inkokataki manchi matalu cheppadam. Being safe ante surakshitanga manchiga undadam. What is that? Safe means we have to, while we have to move one place to another place by the two wheeler, three wheeler or bus, car, then we have to go proper way. We have to follow the traffic rules. In our homes, children are helpless also there. In that, such as sharp objects like knife, blade, scissors, we have to avoid to the children, because it is hard to the children. They can lose their blood. And we do not give to play with the sharp objects to the children. Like, we not allow to the strangers to say our children. When we have to not there in our home, we say to the children, don't allow them strangers inside the home. And we have to say electric switches and gauges, we have to do not touch with wet hands, because it may be sharp. And we have to do not play with the electricity. In school, we have to go to proper way. And while we have to go to the bus, we have to follow the queue system. While we step into the bus, while we step out the bus also, we have to follow the queue system. We should not play in the classroom. So we should not jump in the benches to another benches. We should not run in the classrooms, because we may fall down. It hurt to the our body. These are the safety rules in our schools and roadside while we are going to outside of the house. In this, now we have to go to the road safety and roads. What is the rules? We have to follow the safety rules. We should follow the rules of the traffic, that when we have to stop, what is the symbol will come, which color light will come? Red. We have to wait, yellow color light will come. Green means we have to move, we have to cross the road. See, we should walk on the footpath. Yes, we have to always walk on the footpath. For that, we have to walk on the place only. We should use zebra crossing to cross the road. We should use to zebra crossing when we have to cross on the road. While we are going to, white paint is there lining black road. That is called zebra crossing. This is the road. Here it seems somewhere. We have to cross the road here only. This is called zebra crossing. Then we have to cross the road where have a zebra crossing. We should look to right first. We should look to right and then to left, and then we should cross the road. We should cross the road. What is that? We should look the right and left. After, we should cross the road. We should always obey the traffic rules. Yes, we should compulsory obey the traffic rules, because of traffic constable will be there. They have the signals to go and stop, wait. He will inform to you. Our traffic lights also there, red, green, yellow. Red belongs to that stop, yellow belongs to wait, green belongs to move. See, I will show traffic lights signal. This is. See, we always walk on the footpath only. Beside the road, one road is there, that is called footpath. We should walk to there. And we should cross the zebra lines when we want to cross the road. We should cross the road when we have zebra crossing. This symbol to walk to cross the road. See, you observe the children are going to cross the road. One symbol is there walking the human being. One teacher is there and he is there beside of the traffic lights also. This is called zebra line, zebra crossing.
And one more thing is there, see here, we have to obey the traffic rules, because the traffic constable say to the stop to the children to move, the vehicle can move, and after that vehicle to say stop, traffic constables to stop, the children are moving to cross the road. After cross the road children, the vehicle will move. Then we should always obey the traffic rules. Then we accident will not occurred. When we not obey the traffic rules, the accidents will occur. The safety with safety, why we have to play? Yes, we should not play. We never play on roads, because the vehicles run on roads. Then we should not. We never play on the roads, because on the roads the vehicles are moving. Then we have to play, that accident will happen. That's why we should not play on roads. We should play in the park or playground. Yes, we should play in the park or playground. We should not push to each other while playing. We should not push to others while we have to play. We may get hurt. We have to push to others. We may get hurt. We should not go alone to swimming in swimming pool. We should not go alone with swimming to the swimming pool. We should ask an adult person to come along with us. Yes, we should not go to swim. We should not go alone to swim, because we should go swim the swimming pool too with our elders or parents or cousins, because we have to danger in that place. Then we should not go to swimming pool. We should ask an adult person to come along with us. Good touch and bad touch. What is the good touch? What is the bad touch? We have to feel. See, good touch is the touch out of care, love and affection. The touch we have to give to feel the caring, the love and affection. And bad touch is that one of the which makes us feel unsafe and scared. The bad touch will feel feel unsafe and scared. Bhayapadtam aa touching you are feel avutani. We must not let anyone to touch in any way that we do not like. See, any persons are not touching to our private places, such as neck, like that places. We feel unsafe. We can avoid that persons. That must not let anyone to touch in any way that we do not like. We should say no. Don't touch, no. When someone touches our private parts, when we touches our private parts, someone's, we should say, don't touch. No, don't touch. We have to say in loud voice. We should tell our parents about it. Yes, we should. That incident happened in any places. We should inform to our parents that someone, that person will touch these places. Then I will shout on them to inform to our parents. That is the bad touch. It is harmful to us. We should say no, loud voice. Don't touch. No. Like that we have to say. I will show some pictures to you. See, this is that we should not play on roads because vehicles are moved. This is the bad habit, and we should play on parks and playgrounds. Then we should not push in while we are playing to others. It is we have get hurt. And we should not go alone with the swimming pool to swim, because it is dangerous to us. We should go with our elders, our cousins, our brothers to take it to go to the swim, to the swimming pool. And this is that about the bad touch, about the good touch. We can feel the good touch is the love and care and affection. We can feel the bad touch is the unsafe and scared we have to feel. That's why we have to say loud voice, no, don't touch to us, our private plates. You have to say like that, okay na? and here itself then some state is there whether it is true or false. We should play on the road. No, false. We should never walk on the footpath. It is also false. We should not push each other while we playing. It is very good. That is true. We should always go along with swimming. No, that is false. Only one true. First one false. Second one false. Third one true. Fourth one false. Up to here we have to finish the summary. Safety about that summary of the lesson. This is the summary of the lesson. At home, do not play with the sharp objects and electric items. Do not play with the match sticks and or fight. In school, we should not push other, fight and each other. We wait for the turn to get into the school bus. And the road, we have to walk on footpath. We use zebra crossing to cross the road, looking right and left, then cross the road. Next, while playing, do not push each other. Do not play on the roads. These are the summary of the lesson. Up to here, we have to finish. Children, you should complete application book. Okay, na? Thank you.